So we're going to go over how to use the chemical structure search in SciFinder. Now this is good if you are looking for maybe a specific compound or derivatives of a specific compound. So what I am going to do is I'm going to draw the structure of fentanyl, which is a drug that you see used as a painkiller. You also kind of see it in the media nowadays because it is commonly abused. So this is called ChemDraw. I would recommend messing around with it a little bit. It can be a little bit intimidating, but it's not that difficult to use once you get the hang of it. I think it's kind of fun. I like to draw in ChemDraw. Okay, so we have our structure. So now we get to choose what kind of search we want to do. You can do your exact structure, which will look exactly for what you put into ChemDraw, but it might also show some things like different stereoisomers, if there's radicals in it, if it's charged, things like that. You can do a substructure search where you should have the main compound that you drew, but you might have some different groups coming off of it. And then you have a similarity search, which kind of will just look for compounds that are similar. You can also do an advanced search where if you're looking for something very specific, you can limit it by characteristic classes or studies, but we're just going to do a basic substructure search. So what we see right away is our top contender is the exact structure that we looked for. And you can see this because the structure is in red. All the different structures that don't match exactly, if there's different groups coming off of it, you can see that that is in black. So let's go ahead and look at this structure here. And I did mention that this is fentanyl. So just to confirm that it is fentanyl, you can look at these other names and you can see the fentanyl right there. Here you can look through the different properties of the structure. You can find spectra, which are very important if you're doing research or if you are doing a lab where you need to compare literature spectra to. You can also, with your substance, if you really like the substance, you can select it. And by selecting it, you can choose to get different references for it where you might see it being cited. You can get reactions that are specific with this substance, and you can find out where to get it commercially. So based on your search, you can also do this keep me posted alert. It'll send you a notification anytime something new might be published about it. Or you can also use whatever compound you selected and send it to your SciPlanner so you can go back and look at it later. And then you also have a bunch of different ways that you can analyze your search by. You can sort it through a bunch of different options. This tool is very good to use for searching for structures and their properties and maybe some derivatives of that structure.